All right, you guys, welcome to class. This is going to be more of a yin practice, meaning it's going to be really slow. I want you to have all the support that you might need. So grab your two blocks and your bolster, which should just be like a thick pillow that works really well. And know that these postures you'll be holding for about 3 to 5 minutes. I want this one to be really focused on your hips and your pelvic floor, your low back, anything really in this region, okay, front and back and side. So if you are feeling like you're at your edge for a lot of these, I want you to use your props to help support you, and I'll cue you into those, okay? We're gonna keep it really easy and light to start. So come to the back of your mat and keep your blocks up at the front. If you have tight hips already, you can start with your knees a little closer together. If you have a bolster or pillow that you want to use in between your legs, that can feel really supportive. You can even actually put it underneath your butt if you want to, and let yourself lay flat forward. But if you don't need the support, you could just lay on the ground like normal. And start to take some deep breaths. Notice what you feel in your body and in your hips. Notice if your monkey mind is rattling around. Can you begin to calm it down by coming to your breath over and over? Remember that every breath is a new opportunity to begin again. Can you really drop into this moment by making your hips heavier? Noticing where your ankles or just your shins make contact with the ground. With every breath out, can you make your heart a little more heavy, a little heavier, and just surrender it into the ground? You can rock your forehead from right to left, just massage this muscle that actually gives you a lot of control over your facial expressions. And steady your head into stillness again, and check in with your shoulders. Can you make your shoulders even heavier, softer, stretching in your underarm, through your lats and triceps? Make your forearms really heavy and just release the grip that you may have in your hands. Maybe you pick a heart and intention or have an affirmation for yourself that you want to keep repeating to yourself just silently. I am present. I'm grateful. I can breathe. Just fill something in with I am blank. And while your breath is the navigating thing that takes you through this practice, you could always come back to that intention to recognize again what you came on your mat for. Take another moment here. And just go really slow. Stretch out your arms, stretch out your fingers towards the top of your mat. You feel a little bit of yang energy. Take a breath in, pick yourself up into tabletop. Come into all fours. Gently push your hips from right to left. knowing that you don't have to move very much or very big. Okay, slowly start to make your way down onto your belly. And then walk your elbows underneath your shoulders. So for yin, you really don't want to actually use a lot of muscular energy. You just want to kind of sink into the softer tissue and really relax there at your edge. So instead of pushing the ground away for this one under your elbows, I want you to let your chest sink down and then let your chin come down towards your chest.
Notice if you feel anything at the top of your shoulders and into your neck, and just take some breaths.
Just as a reminder, Robin's doing everything that you should be doing for the most part. And I'll give you different angles by showing you from the side. If you have any questions, just look to her.
Let's take a few more right here. And slowly start to rock your head from left to right. Feeling out the sides of your neck, your shoulders, and even into your low back. Check in with this here. Last one. Come back to stillness right in the middle.
Start to pick yourself up back into all fours. Put your left hand down right underneath your face. You can walk your knees out a little bit wider so you have more support. Take a breath in and reach your right arm all the way up to the sky. Feel that stretch. You can even keep your eyes closed. Circle out your wrists in both directions. And slowly weave yourself down into a twist. Right shoulder will come to the earth or to a block. You can let your right side of your head come to the floor. And your left hand can stay right by your face, or it can reach up towards the top of the mat. Or you can take a half bind. Reach your left arm all the way around to the back so that your fingers touch your inner right thigh. Remember, you don't have to use a lot of muscular energy, maybe more so into your bottom shoulder, so your right shoulder, but you can let your hips sway with you to the left. And just breathe wherever you feel this, in your mid-back or the back of your shoulder. You shouldn't have any pain in your neck whatsoever. Hold this. Keep breathing. And even though this is yin, right, not a lot of muscular energy, there's still a little energetic component with your presence and with your breath. So if you feel your exhale giving you that space to move in deeper, you can always move in a little deeper. Take three more breaths right here. One more. Slide your left hand down back by your face. Push into the ground as you breathe in. Reach your right arm high to the sky for a counter stretch. Exhale and place your right hand back down below your face. We'll switch it out. Inhale, lift your left arm to the sky. Circle out your wrist while you close your eyes. Notice where you feel all of this. Then when you breathe out, slowly come back down to the floor. Weave your left arm underneath you. Land lightly on your shoulder, followed by your head. So you're looking to the right this time. You're using your right arm to push down into the ground gently to feel this in your upper back a little bit more.
You can just extend the arm all the way to the top of your mat. You can play with half binds again, reaching across your low back for your inner left thigh. With a little hip sway to the right, that's okay, as long as you're just feeling this anywhere around your shoulder on the left side, your upper back, not so much in your neck. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Settle into what you feel. Maybe the legs are starting to talk back to you. Don't be here for too much longer. Let's take three more breaths here. Take your breaths in and out of your nose. Gently bring your right hand back to your face on the floor. Push into it as you breathe in. Reach your left arm high to the sky. Open up your heart. You can let your hips sway to the left even. Then let your left hand come all the way down. Okay, slowly start to walk onto your feet. Lift your knees. Walk your feet up towards the top of your mat so you're close to your blocks. Just take a breath in. Come to a halfway lift. Energize your upper back. And shift your hips forward so they're right over your heels. Breathe out. Slowly let yourself ragdoll forward. You can stay supported on the blocks with your elbows, with your hands. If you feel comfortable and supported with your feet wide enough, about hip width is good. Just let your arms tangle around each other. Drop your weight into your toes and into your head. Imagine your pelvis spilling forward. Your sits bones are lifting as high as they can towards the sky, towards your ceiling, and your crown is dripping all the way to the floor. So the funny thing about yin is that when you're still and holding a posture for a fairly long time, the mind starts to chatter a little bit louder. So it makes it a different challenge. It's a different kind of practice to stay present, stay committed. Remember, once we get past the muscular tissue, right, we're breathing into kind of the more superficial areas first, and then you can get into the deep tissue the longer you stay. If you start to feel any numbness in the backs of your legs, just bend your knees slightly, give yourself some more support and prop yourself up. Use the blocks. You kind of have to test it out in your body for this one to find a center point to balance on. Thank you. Deep breathing, keep going. Take two more breaths, finding your depth here. And then slowly breathe in, use your blocks, come to a halfway lift. Okay, just to move a little bit of energy around, start to bend into your knees one at a time, pedal out. Maybe shift your hips from side to side a bit. Have the leg that's straight. So you start to feel into your outer hips. Okay. Reach for your blocks. Give yourself a little room to step back with your left foot. Lower your knee down to the earth. Walk your right foot really wide, maybe as wide as your mat, and push your hips forward until you get a stretch on your left hip flexors and the back of your right hip, or even the inside of your right hip. So you can stay right here, or you can lower down into your elbows, either on the blocks or all the way to the floor. Remember, we're not trying to focus on so much muscular energy as much as we want to just feel as supported as possible. So that could look like grabbing the bolster and laying on it. And know that this knee, it can stay on top of your ankle, but it doesn't have to stay in. It can fall out a little bit if you feel like you don't have to exert as much energy. Don't worry about what your back foot is doing. I'll come check on you guys. You can just let your head hang and know that that will feel a little bit different for you. Your left leg, all that fascia in the front is connected to the fascia across your back and up over your head. You can always change up the position. We're going to hang out here for a good 3 minutes. So I want you to make sure you're comfortable. If you're not feeling enough or you don't feel stable on that right leg, try walking your foot forward slightly to feel more in your glutes. And just come back to your breath, in and out of your nose. Start releasing any tension just out through your nose. Just get in the mind. Nice job, you guys. Start to take your time walking yourself up. I want you to push your hips back slightly so that you can walk your right foot all the way across to the left side of your mat. And slowly let your shin, your knee come down. Start to walk that left knee back a little bit more so that your pelvis feels heavy. I don't care if you're pushed over onto your right side or pushed over to your left side. Just get wherever your body wants to go here. Take a breath in, lift up your chest. Breathe out slowly, lower yourself down. You can use, again, that bolster out in the front if you want for support for your chest. If you need a little more support underneath your hips, you can also take the bolster under there, under your right butt cheek, and lower down onto the blocks. You get another principle of yin, right, is that you don't force your body into shapes it doesn't want to be in. This practice is about surrendering into what you feel and letting your body kind of take that pathway of least resistance. Just really more paying attention to the breath. In this posture, if you feel anything in the knee, start to give yourself more of a lift. You should feel most of this happening in your right glute, maybe your inner thigh. Hold for another couple of minutes. So let yourself get comfortable. Notice where your mind starts to take you. Just practice being the watcher, the observer of those thoughts. Deep slumber, walk yourself up slowly onto your elbows, and then your hands. So if you have a block underneath you or a bolster underneath you, go ahead and slide that out. Lean over onto your right hip and take your left leg all the way through to the front with your right foot on the inside of your thigh. And you can give yourself, again, a little prop up on your bolster, on a block, or you can kind of preemptively set yourself up, something like this, or even like that. Okay, take a breath in, and just try to sit up as tall as you can, a little active dorsiflexion to start. So pull your toes up towards your face. When you breathe out, let yourself lean forward and let your arms collapse over the support you have. Just relax your leg. It's okay if your knee and your toes point out to the side. Relax your head, your shoulders. We'll be here for another 3 minutes. If your knee bends, that's okay too. Keep channeling your breath in and out of your nose. Slowly climb yourself up. Scoot your props off to the side. Slide your left leg back behind you so you can come back onto all fours. Give your hips a little sway. Move that energy around in some hip circles. Going twice in one direction and then twice in the opposite. Pause right in the middle, tuck your toes under, lift your knees, come back to that forward fold for a split second using your blocks to help you up. Just take a breath in, find a halfway lift. When you breathe out, let's step the right leg all the way back. Lower down onto your right knee, widen out your stance. Some sides will feel different. Right, you can stay with this wide stance. You can let the knee fall out to the side if that feels more doable for you. Feel free to play with the height of your blocks, lowering yourself down. Try to just get yourself to completely fall into this form, whatever this feels like or looks like for you. It doesn't have to be perfect. That doesn't matter here. This is a practice of surrender, so we'll be here for 2 minutes. Thank you. 2 to 3 more breaths right here. Slowly climb yourself up. You can shift your hips back a second as you grab your blocks and start to walk your foot across your mat over onto the right side. And just shift yourself forward, lower your shin down. It can be at whatever angle feels right for you tonight. And then just play with getting your hips as low as you can, supported on blocks or your bolster. Take a breath in, pick up your chest. And breathe out, make your way down. We're gonna hang out there for a few. Let yourself get deeper with your breath. Where are you holding tension and where are you exerting any muscular energy? The interesting part of this practice too is that this is the quiet side. This is the yin side. And where you transition between each posture, that's where the yang is. That's where the effort is. This should not feel effortful. Take 2 more breaths. Start to shift your weight up onto your elbows and your hands. Get your blocks or props out of your way so you can lean over onto your left hip. Use your hands if you need to slide your right leg forward. And you can grab your setup now in front of your chest. Sometimes that means just sticking blocks on top of a bolster and snuggling it nice and tight towards your center. Take a breath in and just lift your chest slightly. A deep breath out. Try to get your heart or your chest up and over your bolster. And then just relax the effort in your leg and in your foot, and even in your head. Thank you. Keep coming back to your deep breathing. Think of your mantra or your affirmation. Let that fill your body up. Let it fill your mind up. Take three more deep breaths here. Your next breath in, smoothly rise back up. Cool. Take your bolster off to the side. Have both of your blocks handy at the middle of your mat and scooch your tush to the middle of your mat. Bring the soles of your feet together. You can try a few different options with your blocks. If your knees don't fall all the way down comfortably, you can use the blocks underneath your thighs and your shins like that before you lay back down, or you can insert them when you're already on your back. If you feel like your knees comfortably lay here, that's fine. You don't have to use blocks. If this doesn't feel like enough when you lay down, you can put your feet on top of your blocks together to help lift them up a little higher, and then your knees have someplace to go. So take your time coming all the way to your back. And then just find the setup that works for you for this one. You can play with how close your heels are to your groin. It just means that you're stretching a little bit of a different area the further your feet are away from you, but let them go where they kind of want to go. Like if you start close and let them slide out, that's okay. You can put your hands on your hips or one hand on your heart and then your belly. I want to be mindful of your time. We are a minute away from that mark. I want to offer you this time and space to stay longer and do a proper shavasana. You can even use this particular posture as your last pose for rest. Whether or not you stay in this pose, you're gonna stay connected with the inhale, the pause at the top, and your smooth matching exhale, and the pause at the bottom. Breathe awareness into your pelvic floor. Watch it work with your belly, with your breath, just in your mind's eye. Let your thigh bones anchor themselves into the earth and your hips back into their sockets. You can stay here longer. Otherwise, take your time using your hands to guide your knees together. Give yourself a little squeeze. You can kick your blocks off to the side and stand your back. Lengthen your legs out. Push into the back of your head to help lift your shoulder blades together. Underneath your heart, with your palms face up, toes relaxed out. Take one more big inhale through your nose and an open mouth exhale. Know that you can stay here as long as you'd like, even longer, past what we're doing right now. Give yourself at least 10 breaths together here. If you want to stay longer, you're more than welcome. Listen to your body. If it's requiring or asking for rest, know that that's okay. Just disregard my voice. If you're ready, you can begin with deeper and more intentional breaths in and out until you can make some movements into your hands and your feet intuitively. Take your stretch all the way up overhead and through your toes. Then bend your knees and roll over onto one side. Just remember that stillness and the pause are just as important as the movement or the doing. Find some gratitude for moving a little bit slower today on your mat. Notice what came up for you. And if you want to carry that mantra or affirmation that you made earlier off into the rest of your evening or your day, you can do that. When you're ready, lift yourself up into a seat with a long spine. Bring your hands gently into your heart space. And we'll close with one more breath together. Empty out your breath first, out through your mouth or your nose. Take a new breath in through the nose. Exhale to give it back. Thank you guys so much for coming. From our hearts to yours. Namaste. Namaste.